Hello, my name is Niels Henrik Hollander. I'm a senior medical oncologist at Zealand University Hospital in Denmark. And where are we? We are working a group, a consortium, together in the northern part of the EU, a cooperation between Denmark and the northern part of Germany. And I will tell you about our first experiences with taking blood samples in patients' own home. We do it by this device called HemoQ to white blood cell differentiation counting system. It is manufactured by a Scandinavian company and is CE marked only for the use of professionals. But we have been able to test the device in patients' home. And this is the authors of the manuscript that you will see later. And in summary, we have discovered that the accuracy of the HemoQ are clinical acceptable, and the device can be used for monitoring, self-monitoring in cancer patients' home. Before we did the test in patients' home, we made laboratory testing a lot of blood samples from both cancer patients and hematological patients to see the variation over the white blood cell count and over the neutrophil cell count. And it has been a collaboration between our department at Zealand University Hospital, University College Absalon, which is a nurse school, the design school of Kolding, that are looking upon man-machine interaction when patients are doing their self-test at home. And then we have a service organization inside the region Zealand called Production Research and Innovation that has been running this part of the project. Why test at all in patients' home? It's prescribing cancer treatment without the patient having to visit outpatient clinic or laboratory is in the interest of patient. The patient can avoid the transportation, which often, at least by Danish measurement, can be more hours of transportation to hospital or to a laboratory before getting chemotherapy. And of course, we also look upon the probably a possibility for financial gains by using this. And who have we tested? We tested breast cancer patients in adjuvant or neoadjuvant treatment. We had the decision to have 18 tests or above, and an equal distribution of age over and under the age of 60. And I'm sorry, this treatment scheme is in Denmark, but it's an international way to treat adjuvant therapy of breast cancer patients and to have taken blood samples before every 3 weeks next course of chemotherapy. And we, of course, have done both the testing by the patient in the patient's home and by the laboratories. Blood samples was, of course, taken in the patient at the patient's home and by the laboratory. And we could also, at the same time, register side effects that the patient could write down and compute into the system. During the project, we made a hotline so the patients could call us We have made interviews of those outpatient clinic nurses running the therapy in our clinic, and we have done interviews of the patients, and of course also made on-site observations in the patient's home, how they performed these tests. We have got at the preliminary report, as we have published, 14 patients in 2017. From the patient's perspective, of course, it was important that they could look for less transport. And what was also important for the patients, that they could follow their own measurement. And what they reported was that this device, the HemoQ, was easy to use. We did see some problems with the needles when the patient have to draw blood from their capillaries at the fingertip. But it's our opinion that there are good prospects in the future for this device. And concerning the hotline, we only experienced 10 calls from the patient, and the calls were by needle errors. And we have tried to fix that online or by giving the patients new needles. And these are the main results where we are seeing the white blood cell count and the neutrophil count by the laboratory, and the same done by the HemoQ. And if you are interested in more details, please go to the article we have published. Now I will go to another item we are using to test if new devices can help changing cancer care to make it more easy. And we are cooperating with a small company that have made a device, and I will tell about that now. It is called Cortrium, and the device is called C3. And over the time table here, you can see that from the start of the company having the idea to make this item till we got it into the hospital, and we had it adjusted so there was not so many holes in the device that could host bacteria, etc. And on the right side, you see the final product that you put on the patient's chest. And the patient, at least when the patient is hospitalized, the patient has not to be awake at night, because we can online see the patient's respiratory rate, the heart rate, even the ECG, and the temperature on the skin. And compared to those technologies that today, the equipment that are used today, we have taken two examples here. And of course, it's more easy to use with this little device. And also the resources using the device have, of course, been reduced significantly. So this is how the final product, and again, due to EU regulatory authorities, to use such a device at patients need what we call a CE marking. And it is important for the company to get to the marketplace when this has been done. And of course, there is a lot of paperwork to do for the authorities to get this done. We believe that capturing Denmark as part of the Scandinavian hospital system that is tax financed and free for all, cover the Scandinavian hospital financing model, And we have done the same in Germany, and Germany represent the Central European way to organize their services at hospitals, and they do have a large private sector. And of course, there were some cumbersome things to get this CE marking, but the company has got it and have now marketed it in Germany. And these are the key players in this process. And of course, the company is very proud of having this CE marking, so they can marketing their product all over Europe. And now I will turn to our last project. We have named Changing Cancer Care, and a significant part of that project is to look upon the curriculum for future study nurses, what they have to learn when we incorporate new technical devices into the care of the patient, and even put these devices back to patients' home. And this work in this project, Changing Cancer Care, is done by the nurse school called Absalon. And of course, again, the background is that the number of cancer patients is rising, the cancer patients live much longer, and we have got a lot of new drugs to prescribe to the patients. And that's a general problem over Europe, that the number of oncologists, nurses, etc. Cannot cope with so large rise in and number of patients have to be treated. So we have to look upon other ways to do the treatment. It is evident that many of the tasks in cancer treatment generate workloads for healthcare professionals. And there is a wish for new evidence-based research with nursing care and cancer. Further, the patient need a gentle and logic way through their treatment in order to maintain their quality of life despite being in a cancer treatment. And the aim for Changing Cancer Care is to develop, test, and implement new methods and pathways of the healthcare professionals as well for the patients, and exploring and develop new tools for diagnostic and treatment in oncology that enhance the survival rate and reduce the cost. And thereby developing a curriculum that enables nurses to shift some of the tasks undertaken in cancer treatment and care with doctors in order for the patients to receive a gentle treatment and a smooth transition in the hospital. We will develop tools and methodology. We will make desk research in a systemic review. We will do field works at the hospital and do qualitative and quantitative questionnaire research to exploring existing knowledge and design a new curriculum with the patient, doctor, and nursing perspective in the center, and develop a test of a curriculum enhancing work shift between doctors and nurses in the cancer treatment. All this have been sponsored through 10 years through the EU, and here are our collaborators. And what I will do for my final presentation is to show you a slide film made on our General Assembly, where we did the General Assembly as part of the nursing school's ordinary treatment, and you will have some responses from the young training nurses.
EnuCAN-projektet går ud på, at vi på tværs af grænserne undersøger, hvordan velfærdsteknologi kan blive implementeret ved ældre patienter med cancer. Noget af det særlige ved det her projekt, det er, at vi helt fra starten af har inkluderet de studerende og har medinddraget dem i den forskning, der sker ude i afdelingerne. Ved at inddrage de studerende i vores EnuCAN-projekt, der sker der det, at de dels får en indsigt i, hvad det er, hvordan man går fra læring til forskning og til at implementere det ude i samfundet. Og de bliver bedre klædt på, når de skal ud og arbejde med det her velfærdsteknologi i deres dagligdag som sygeplejersker.
Når man får noget rigtig virkelighed ind i sin undervisning, så kan man jo også godt se, at alt det, man sidder med i teorien og sådan noget, det er faktisk noget, man kan bruge ud i praksis. Og man kan bruge det som sygeplejerske, når man bliver færdig. Så det er rigtig godt at få med i sin undervisning og ligesom få et virkelighedsbillede på det.
Noget af det, jeg får tilbage fra studerende, er jo nogle andre vinklinger på ting. De tænker tingene anderledes, end jeg gør som projektdeltager og som underviser. Så nogle af de spørgsmål, de har, eller nogle af de sådan, tankegange, de har, de kan godt være lidt skæve, men det er jo også noget, hvor man tænker, det havde jeg egentlig ikke overvejet.
Altså meget af det, vi får fra de studerende, og som vi tager med tilbage til EnuCAN-projektet, det har ligget omkring det med de etiske overvejelser. Det er de super dygtige til, og de er sådan set vores sparringspartner, når vi diskuterer nogle af de her dilemmaer, som der ligger inden for ny teknologi og sygepleje.
Noget af det, vi også arbejder med, det er jo at inkludere dem i den hverdag, vi andre har. En af tingene, det er jo at tage med på en konference for at få formidlet, for at få bundet det bindeled til, fra den teoretiske undervisning i klasselokalet, til at de så hører, at det her det bliver anvendt i praksis.
Så man føler sig som en del af det, når man bliver lukket ind til sådan en konference her. Altså man føler, at man er en del af den her virkelighed, også selvom man bare er studerende, fordi vi er ligesom en vigtig faktor i det her, fordi vi er fremtidens sygeplejersker. Ja, det giver en bedre indsigt i, altså hvad det er, vi egentlig som studerende, vi kommer til også at skal lave, blandt andet med vores bachelorprojekt og det innovative projekt, vi har på 6. semester. Hvor kompleks det egentlig er, og hvad for nogle udfordringer, man ligesom kan møde undervejs.
Thank you.